pulling it right underneath the fire so I can just, as soon as it's hot enough, I can dab it onto it.
But it's not actually in the fire, just a little rod.
Yeah. Okay. Action of honey. Got my plenty on there. Now I'm gonna start melting the piece. Sometimes I'm a little more comfortable putting it in my right hand because I'm right-handed, the plenty. And then I don't really go and hit the plenty. See, the flame does, you're not supposed to hit the
plenty at all.
No, or over here.
Or over there.
Okay. It's like right. See, if you can see, the flame is kind of bouncing off down there, but not a whole bunch.
Okay.
I'm not like all the way down there like that. Right about here.
And if it wants to turn?
I'm turning it on purpose.
Okay.
With my right hand in favor. I'm just spinning it and kind of just following with this one, but not like trying to spin it at the same speed. Oh, I got that nice and melted down. Still spinning a lot with this right hand. Yeah, I'm gonna pull it down a little bit. The key will pop. Yeah, keep going. Now that I'm out of the flame, I can pull it a little bit. Blow once again. Still got decent wall thickness.
That's what the blow is helps create.
Well, right? it took some of the thickness away, so I don't have to worry about it breaking as easy.
Okay.
Now I'm gonna hit this end and I'm gonna spin with this left hand more. And this is a wig wag. I'm really careful not to get too far up the end there. I'm going to pull it out of the fire and twist it. Out of the fire, twist. Yeah.
Another blow to keep it
from closing. Out of the fire, twist. Okay, I think that's pretty much under control. I can kind of twist in the flame. I'm out of the flame now, twisting. Do another blow. Then I can kind of push together even more after I've blown out. Okay, I think the mouthpiece is done. Now, I'm going to get more comfortable, put my hand of favor, my right hand, and I'm going to be really careful when I go into this. So I can't put this in the flame immediately. I got to introduce it. And I'm not staying in the fire, I'm going up, out of the flame, into the flame, out of the flame, into the flame.
Flashing it.
Yeah. So kind of slowly but surely, it's going to get hot enough to where I can hold it in the flame.
So those motions gradually get smaller and smaller as you go?
Yeah.
Okay.
Mainly, yeah. Okay, now that it's hot enough, I can hold still. And I'll probably want my center fire, so I'm not heating my punny too much. Getting that part really hot, because I'm going to wig it back the other direction. Once it gets hot enough, I'll be able to twist it back. I'm actually doing it now, but not really that much. Once it gets hot enough, I'm going to take it out of the flame and twist it back the other direction. Put it back in the flame and get it hot again. Oh, now I'm able to twist in the flame. It's letting me.
Is that because
it's out of the flame twist. Because what?
Because it's a thicker part of the glass, is that why it's letting you?
I don't know why. Just have the mind in the phone.
The way it goes, okay.
Okay, now I'm going to heat the very end where the punny is. Keep the punny on there. Now that it's hot enough, I'm going to give it a blow and a twist. With my right hand in favor. With you, it would probably be with your left hand in favor. So it would be the opposite. You'd probably be more comfortable holding this tube in your left hand.
Low tube.
Yeah, either that or the punny.
Yeah.
Yeah, I was more comfortable holding the punny in my right hand when I was working on the shaft of the piece. But now I'm working on the end of it, so I'm more comfortable holding the tube. Because I'm right-handed. Now they got that wigged and wagged. I'm going to heat it up. Kind of let it ball up. I'm not really trying to make it ball up. It's just doing it, you know? I'm not letting it separate.
Okay.
I push together a little bit. After you blow, you can really push more. Okay, now that I have that done, I'm going to twist off the front. Heat it up. I'm trying to twist too much now. Now I'm out of the fire. I'm going to give it a twist and a blow. There. I'm going to pull that off. That's a termination. Now that I got my termination done, I heated it a little bit. Once it collapses, give it a little puff. I'll repeat that a couple times. Not too much blowing. A little puff, keep it out. I'm going to heat the rest of it up again. Have it level when I'm blowing out in most cases. Like completely level, straight. Real quick.
You'll be blowing a bubble like that.
Yeah.
Okay.
And since the mouthpiece getting cold again, flash in the flame. I'm going to use the length of the flame to heat the rest of the stem. But I'm not staying in the flame.
Are you turning as you're doing this?
Of course.
Yeah, okay.
I don't usually ever hold it still like that. I don't. Unless, of course, I'm making something flat, and then I'll flip and stop on both sides if it's flat, and if I rotated it, it would make it round again. Thickening up the front a little bit. Seemed like it needed some thickening. There. We'll let that cool a little bit so it doesn't just pop right back out. A little blow to keep it round. Okay, now that that's cooled off, we'll go into the main part of the ball. Get it all hot, and I'm going to rise out of the flame. Hold it level. Puff out. I'll keep that tip in. I'm working mainly on the end of it, and I'm tipping it up because I want that to kind of sink in. There, that's good. And I'll hold it level again. Okay, now we pick where we want our bull hole. In the bull hole, you need to pump it out like right about there. Not at the very top, but a little lower.
Back a little more towards the stem.
But not too far back.
Okay.
So I'm gonna lower my flame. And I'm gonna pinpoint that spot where I want the bull hole to be. Right there, and I'm holding it pretty close, so it hits that, pinpoints it.
Mm-hmm.
Like right under the center, right there. And if I were to be one hole over, I'd be at the top.
Okay.
Next hole down.
That's a good way to judge it.
Yeah. Now this is a good one to know. A wrist twitch like this, but in a circular motion. I'm gonna do that with the other hand. Around the bowl where you envision your bowl to be. And the bowl hole is starting to get too small. So I'll hold in the flame and blow. That opened up the hole a little bit.
I just want to kind of keep an eye out for that in case you guys do it.
It wants to close, yeah. Pretty close when I do that because I want that pinpointing flame really sharp and exact. Now it's hot enough. Mouthpiece first. Smaller flame and polish out this bowl so it's not weak.
Yeah, pusher marks.
Pusher marks are okay, it's the stretch marks that you don't want.
Okay.
If it's got nothing but pusher marks, I wouldn't worry about it as much, but I always hit it with a flame.
Okay.
The heat marks kind of look cool. It's got to be this the right timing. Okay, now I'm going to hit the bottom, doing it a little back and forth, and I'll switch hands at the bottom of that hand. nice and hot. Put it, plug it up, blow it out, and then slam it down. You don't want to blow too much, but I like to do that.
Just enough to.
Now I polished it. Started pretty close, damn close, and then moved out. There. Polish it again. Yeah, and then I'm gonna flash my mouthpiece in the flame. Keep it hot. Or you could just throw it in the kiln so you wouldn't have to worry about it. Like once you finish your pull, like especially you as a beginner, won't want to have to do this because you aren't fast enough. I'm just fast enough to where I can heat it back up.
Practice hand. Yeah. That takes the practice hand.
Okay, I got the whole pipe done except for the carb. I think I want to put a kryptonite marble on.
Nice. Nice color.
Just pinpointing a spot for it.
And keeping it warm.
And then I'm rounding this out. Yeah. Making it a little rounder, you know? Now that it's round enough, I have my piece directly under the flame. I'm just gonna stomp it on there. Spiral out like that. Now I'm not hitting the piece, I'm just hitting the marble. Get an even sharper little flame. Triple mix, lower your green to where it points out like that. I'm going to get the edges where I stomped it down all melted in. All the way around it. Now that I have them melted in, I can kind of like focus on the whole marble again. Turn my green up, turn my propane up. All right, kind of, you know. Now I got a shape back. Okay, now I'm going to lower down to a pinpoint flame again. Lower that green just enough to where it gets sharp. Pinpoint a spot. And since I was this way for so long, I'm going to hold it this way.
Oh, upside down.
Yeah.
Okay.
And if I was upside down, I'm gonna hold it this way.
On here, plug it up all holes so you can get that carb hole.
Yeah. I got my carb pumped out, so if I were to just want to blow a carb right now, all they have to do is hold it in the flame and blow a hole. But I'm gonna make a custom carb. So I'm gonna raise my flame up for a minute. Heat it up. Make a little marble out of the color. I heat the carb spot so I remember where it is. See, it's orange.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
All you have to do is hold it in there for a second.
It.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. It's a thin spot and it gets really hot. so I know where I'm at. Just heat it a little bit. Hold it right about there. Swirl it around. As soon as you get that off there, plug it up.
Start blowing.
Okay, now that it pumped out a little bit, I got the air going into the color card.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah, I see it.
Now I'm gonna lower the flame down and do it just as I did with the marble. Go around the base. Yeah. Sealing in that card so it doesn't just pop off there. So much. I'm just trying to get that seal. Puff that out to where it didn't sink in. I'm gonna let that cool for a second. And I'm gonna go into the marble and heat it up, bring the heat back up. I'm gonna switch hands. Get the top, bottom, top. Bottom, top, bottom. Whatever's facing the sky is going to blow out sooner. So if I had a thick spot on here, I point the thick spot up.
Okay.
That way it would blow equally.
Let gravity kind of do the work for you.
Help me out, yeah. Now I got it going. Switch hands because it helps me keep it equal, you know? Looks like it's going pretty equal. A little thicker over here on this end. I'm gonna hold it down. And usually this is all done like this, or like this.
Depending on where the thicker part is.
Yeah, I'm holding it straight on so I can blow. Now either tip it this way, tip it this way, tip it that way. Okay, I got that pretty much puffed out all the way. Yeah. Out of the fire. Okay, now it's ready, so I'm gonna hold it in the fire. But it helps to take it out of the fire to get that.
So it's
puckered out. You know, like, remember when I, before I put the color on? I was puffing out of the fire, not in the fire.
Right. But now you want to keep it in the fire to get your hole.
Yeah, so I don't make trash.
Okay. The last part of getting that.
If it's not big enough, I'm going to get it hot. All around it, do that little twitchy thing. Now that it's open, get in there with my reamer and did a little swirly circle.
Nice ream.
Yes, that's pretty good.
Nice white card too.
But I don't settle with that. I heat it up
because
I don't want it to be soaked that thin. I want it to be a little thicker. So going around, switch hands, go around. Helps to have a little less triple mix for these carbs. That way it covers the whole thing, see?
Okay.
Yay. Got it. Gave it a little roundness there. But really slow light. Didn't even make any marks on it. Done.